New details have been revealed on the King's coronation next month, outlining the procession carriages, the route and the events following the service. For more, let's bring in Royal Editor at the Daily Mirror, Russell Myers. Good morning to you, Russell. We're starting to get an idea of what this day is going to look like.
Yes, we do. We've just been given some brand new details. Good morning, Jane. Well, I think it's all going to be the glitz and glamour you would expect to come from this event. We know that the procession is going to be a real star-studded affair. We're obviously going to see the new king and queen, all the senior members of the royal family. The king and queen will be travelling in the Golden State Coach, which has been used in so many coronations from bygone years. And who else are we going to see? We're going to see all the senior royals on the balcony. Of course, it's going to be all the pomp and pageantry you would expect with a big occasion like this. So, yeah, lots to look forward to.
Will we be seeing Harry and Meghan?
Well, I mean, you know, I'm just giving you all the glitz and glamour and we still come back to Harry and Meghan, don't
we?
But I mean, it is what people are talking about and they have been keeping everybody waiting. Not just us, you know, who are interested in their attendance, but the organisers. They still haven't sent back their RSVP. Mm. We're still none the wiser. They're still keeping everybody hanging. So is there a bit of horse trading behind the scenes? Who knows? But, you know, we are led to believe that they are close to making a decision. So I suppose we'll all hold our breath until they do.
There is this new report out today that says stripping Harry of his Duke of Sussex title is something that has been considered. Do you think that's been a serious discussion?
Well, it appears so. I mean, there's a new book coming out about the king and about sort of his path to taking the top job, as it were. But it was happening. You know, when there was an awful lot of fractiousness between the household and Harry and Meghan were leaving, certainly senior, not necessarily senior members of the royal family, but senior members of the household, the king's right-hand men and women, were discussing it and saying, was it an option? Now, this book says, by Robert Jobson, says that it wasn't an option for the king, that he really tried and wanted to smooth over the passage for Harry and Meghan. Well, we've all seen how that has ended up. You know, we've had Oprah Winfrey interviews, Netflix series, a book by Harry, and the barbs keep on coming, don't they?
Look, the whole thing just makes me really sad on both sides, Russell. We saw pictures out today of the senior royals out and about for Easter. Is there any chance that Harry can patch things up with his family, if not before the coronation, then maybe after?
Well, you know, I agree with you. I think overall it's a really sad occasion, isn't it? Despite all the sort of the rifts and the rumours that we've had about people pinning up each other against walls and throwing each other on dog bowls or whatever, it's a very sad story of a family that's broken apart. And I'm sure the king would try and want that sort of unity and togetherness that he's spoken about as when he was made king. And listen, I don't think we're going to see any patching up and kissing and making up before the coronation. I doubt we'll see it in the immediacy after. But if Harry and Meghan do come, then everybody will be hoping they're on their best behaviour and try not to overshadow this big event. But we'll just have to wait and see.
I mean, with all the glitz and glamour, it'd be hard to overshadow that with those royal processions and the carriages. It's all going to look very spectacular. Russell, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Welcome back. Great to have your company. The King and senior royals have attended their first Easter Sunday service at Windsor Castle since the death of the Queen.
Live now to Europe correspondent Edward Godfrey. Good morning to you, Edward. The King, all smiles this morning.
Yeah, he was. There was no doubt a little bit of sadness there for him for a couple of reasons. But as you say, he and the Queen consort appeared to be in good spirits as they arrived for the Easter Sunday service. Royal blue was certainly the colour of the day, Charles complimenting the Queen consort Camilla. Kate wore a striking blue coat dress with matching clutch and pillpox hat. William and the children in blue also. Louis on his best behaviour, staying close to his mum on what was his first Easter service with the family. There were many other members of the royal family there too. Andrew making a rare appearance, walking behind the king. Princess Anne and Prince Edward were there also, as were the Tyndalls. Now, this is Charles's first Easter Sunday service as king. It's the first since his mother passed away last year. It was held at Windsor, which was a very special place for the Queen. It was the place she called home in her later years, and it was held inside the St George's Chapel, which is her final resting place. So, guys, mixed emotions there for the royals, perhaps, on what was a lovely, sunny and warm, by British standards, Easter Sunday.
Good to hear, Edward. Thank you.